So you've got a URL, a long, ugly URL that you want to share online. First thing we gotta do is turn it into a branded link. But what's the best way to do that, I hear you ask? Well, it all depends. You've got a variety of options when it comes to domains and keywords. So let's take a look at how to craft the perfect branded link for your needs. Unlike generic shortened URLs, brands these days prefer to share a link that incorporates their name. You see, it's not about being short anymore, that's just not as needed. What's more important is the brand. Oh, sorry, it's true. Now, a branded link is made up of three elements: the domain, the TLD, and the slug. Generic URL shorteners, you have no control over any of these elements. They're usually decided for you and have no trace of your brand whatsoever. But when setting up your branded link, you choose the domain and TLD from scratch. And any link you share after that can have whatever slug you like. Sound good? You know, I think so too. Right, let's get into it. First up, the domain. When setting up your branded link, you choose the domain or domains that will become the base for any link that you share. You'll always want to feature your name or your company's name here so you can boost brand awareness and visibility. Don't be afraid to experiment with different spellings or abbreviations, as long as you're confident that your choice retains your brand's identity and makes people think of it straight away. Now that the first half of your domain is sorted, next up, the TLD. Now, there are far more options than just .com or .org, hundreds and hundreds in fact. Now, whether you want to build a personal brand or a business brand, consider using TLDs that are specific to your niche. Create a clear connection between your name and the industry you're in. You know, an artist could use .studio, a restaurant could use .pizza, a financial consulting company could use .finance. This means anyone who sees your links will come to associate your name with what you do, which is perfect. Your brand will be the first thing that comes to mind when they think of your service. Another reason to get creative with the TLD: customize your branded links so they indicate where they'll lead. For example, at Rebrandly, we use .blog for our latest blog posts, .video to share YouTube videos, and .support to help customers contact our help desk. By telling people where they're going when they click the link, there's that extra level of trust in the content that you share. The URL slug, or keyword after the slash, can be whatever you like it to be for each link that you share. When choosing a keyword, you can use this opportunity to share information about the page the link leads to. So, as well as using a .blog TLD, you could include the title of the article after the slash. This will build trust, encourage click-throughs, and reduce your site's bounce rate because prospects will know exactly what to expect when they arrive on your site. And that's it! Branded links. They can be short and sweet, but there's a lot of potential packed in there. So, to recap, branded links consist of three key elements. The domain. Include your name to put your brand on your links. The TLD. Tell people where they're going when they click and associate your brand with what you do. And the slug. Customize your links for any and all of your needs. With these, you can create your own custom branded links and start sharing with the world. Let us know in the comments below what you think. Hi everyone, thanks very much for watching. We hope you enjoyed this video. If you liked, please give us a like, share and a subscribe, and do comment below as well if you can. You can see more videos about Rebrandly here on screen in the description or in the sidebar. And until next time, take care.